In a social media post, Philippine lawmaker Mike Defensor says he is going to give away ivermectin to residents of Quezon City despite warnings from regulators on the use of the drug to cure COVID-19. The chairperson of the House Committee on Health warns her colleagues not to encourage the use of ivermectin to treat COVID-19 patients.
I'm so sad on what's happening right now that many are using ivermectin even without the clear benefit, although there are testimonials. But of course, we need to validate testimonials. Medicine is evidence-based, it's not based on testimony or opinion. So I'm just afraid of the safety of our countrymen who are using ivermectin.
The use of ivermectin became a hot topic during the COVID-19 pandemic. Ivermectin is an antiparasitic drug used mostly for deworming. There are two types, a human-grade and veterinary-grade ivermectin. The only registered type of ivermectin in the Philippines is the veterinary grade. But Food and Drug Administration Chief Dr. Eric Domingo says it is still possible to get ivermectin as long as it is prescribed by a doctor and sourced from a pharmacy with a license to compound it.
Of course, if you're going to dispense an antibiotic, you have to have a doctor to see a patient and then write a prescription, and then that prescription goes to maybe a compounding pharmacy and make that for the patient.
Congressman Defensor says his distribution of ivermectin to Quezon City residents will follow the correct protocol. Defensor, who started taking ivermectin after contracting COVID-19, insists he is not violating any law.
I'm not prescribing anything. I'm only giving people access to ivermectin. Alam mo ngayon sa black market, tumataas na yung presyo, ang daming gumagawa, hindi natin alam kung sinong peke. I'm getting it from a compounding laboratory. There is a prescription following the FDA guidelines, and I am giving people access to that. I'm not selling it, I'm giving it for free.
But when asked on who will be accountable if in case one who takes it experiences side effects.
Well, the point is, Neil, is before you're allowed to take it, may consent yung tao. It is an informed consent. And that is parang medical practice naman yan talaga eh. Na ito, inumin ko, i-prescribe ko sa'yo, and yung recipient, pumapayag.
Defensor admits he himself takes ivermectin once every 2 weeks. A lot of those in the medical community have given their warnings on the use of the medicine. Because like other drugs, side effects are a possibility.
Common yan is headache, no? Sometimes they have abdominal pain. Kaya minsan, you have to watch out for that. No?
Sa ganyang mataas na dose po, pwede pong magkaroon ng brain damage ang isang tao at pwedeng mamatay kung ma-overdose ng todo-todo.
The Health Department has earlier said that it does not recommend the use of ivermectin against COVID-19. The World Health Organization has also said that evidence pointing to ivermectin as a cure or prevention for the disease remains lacking. The DOH is now looking into how the lawmaker will distribute the drug to residents. The palace encouraged the public to wait for the FDA's decision and issuance of a compassionate special permit for ivermectin. The agency said it received an application for a CSP last Wednesday. When asked if Defensor, a staunch administration ally, could face liability for the controversy, presidential spokesperson and lawyer Harry Roque refused to give his legal advice. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.